You have good news to share too. Last week I told you about that good news, about how Jesus died for your sins and paid your ticket into heaven. And it's our job to tell people about that good news. If you want to read that story about that man and how that happened to him, you should open your Bible to Luke 1 and read through that chapter. Today we're going to make a craft to share some good news. This is a great craft that you could pop in the mail to someone, hang in your windows at home, share with your neighbors, give to your grandparents. It'd give you something to do during quarantine, and it would also lift a lot of hearts and spirits. So here's what we're gonna make today. It's good news, Jesus loves you, and it's on newspaper. Get it? The good news. We want to tell people that Jesus loves them, especially through this time. A lot of people are feeling down and discouraged, and they need to know that Jesus is still there and loves them. So I'm going to go through the things to make this craft right now. If you have them, after I tell you the materials, pause the video, go get them, and make it with me. If you don't have them, feel free to follow along and have your mom or someone type down in the Facebook comments or send me a message, however you'd like to, and I will get a package of the materials for you to make this craft at home to you. I don't know how that will happen. It could come through the mail. I might recruit pastor's help to deliver it, but I will get you a package so that you can make it if you want. So just let me know if you don't have the stuff, because this would be a great encouragement for someone to get. So we're going to be making this. Good news, Jesus loves you. And here are the things that we need, okay? We're going to need some scrap paper. It can be anything. Here's some pieces I had from doing a lesson with my students. That's going to be your pattern. You're going to need some newspaper, okay? Any old newspaper. Some construction paper or any colored paper, okay? You could recycle a colored paper if you flip it over and it's blank. Absolutely. Some markers of any kind, any size. Markers are going to be the best on the newspaper because crayons don't show up very well. Some glue and some scissors. And of course, you could use tape as well if you needed to. Okay, so here we go. Well, first of all, let's learn how to make a heart template using some scrap paper so that you can make a heart. And if this part is hard for you, you could always have an adult help you make this heart template. So what I did was I just took a piece of scrap paper and I folded it in half, okay? Nice and in half. And then I made half a heart on the fold. Don't do it on the open side, on the fold. So I took my marker and I went for half a heart. And it's kind of hard from here to find a flat spot that I can do it with you. Half a heart. Okay. Now I can cut that out with my scissors. Make sure that's on the fold side. Recruit some help if you need it for this part. Now, when I open this, I have a heart template. It's ready for me to trace. Just scrap old paper. So now we're going to take this, and we're going to take our old newspaper. And there are also free newspapers around town, outside banks and grocery stores, the Free Trader. So if you don't have a newspaper at home, keep your eye out for the next time you're out and about and grab one, and you can do it. And what you're going to do is just pick a page, any page you choose. And I'm going to kind of make it smaller here so I can show you. And we're going to put the heart template on top of the newspaper and trace it, okay? Now this time I picked one that didn't have a picture, because last time I picked one that had a picture and it did make it hard to see my words. So now I just hold that on the newspaper and trace around the heart. And then, of course, guess what you do? You cut it out. I know. Big surprise. So now this newspaper is going to have your good news message on it. Cutting out my newspaper heart. And I didn't fold the newspaper just because I didn't want the fold on my final piece, but if you wanted to do it right here, folded in half, you could. So now I've got a newspaper heart. Oh, look at this side. That's cool. Okay, so then I'm going to pick some colored paper. Remember I said you could use some scrap paper if you have some, or some construction paper. And what I'm going to do is glue this on to the construction paper so that I can go around it to make a border. I'm just using my glue stick around the heart and putting it onto the construction paper, just like that. Now what you want to do is cut again, but this time you stay out away from the heart so that it creates a border. See, I didn't cut right next to the newspaper. I cut out a ways from it. And if you have trouble with this, an adult could take a pen or a marker and make an outline for you so that you know where to cut. But I think most of you will be able to do it, okay? So I'm gonna cut around the outside, leaving some blue all the way around so that it looks good. Just making a nice border. Think of some people you would like to give this to. Maybe you would like to give this to your grandparents or your neighbors, or maybe you'd like to hang this in the window at home. You can make more than one. Make a bunch of them, okay? So there's my heart with some nice blue around the outside. So now I'm going to take a marker, and here is what we want to write. I'm going to get a marker that I know will actually write, because sometimes these Crayolas are a bummer. We're going to write good news, okay? Good news with an exclamation point. That's very important because it's newspaper. So we need our craft to show that. So good, we're going to put capital G, O, O, D. News, let's put a capital N, E, W, S with an exclamation point. And the exclamation point shows excitement. Good news. And what is the good news we want to share with people? We want to share with them that Jesus loves them, that Jesus is there for them. So we're going to put Jesus, capital J, E, S, U, S. Then we're going to put loves. I wanted to put mine capital, so capital L, O, V, E, S. And I don't have room for you next to love, so I'm putting it down underneath. Capital Y, O, U. And then what we want to do is put Jesus loves you in these special little marks called quotation marks, because It's said in the Bible. And these marks show that it is said by someone. So what we do is we put two small marks at Jesus and two small marks at you, because it's very important that that was said for real, that Jesus loves you. Now is the fun part. You get to use your markers and decorate. You can make hearts. You can make flowers. You can highlight words. You can add any colors you want and make it very exciting so that whoever gets this good news from you can have a little cheer and joy in their day and know the good news of the love of Jesus for everyone out there. So just kind of sit there and play with the markers and enjoy making a picture. I hope that you won't stay silent. I hope that you will believe this good news and share it with everyone around you. Remember, if you don't have the materials to make this and you want to, just give me a shout. I will make sure that you get these materials so that you can enjoy sharing the good news. Have a blessed week.